The crew of 8 can row 20 kilometers per hour in still water. The crew rows upstream, then returns to starting point in 15 minutes. If the river is flowing at rate 2 kilometers per hour, how far did the crew row? Okay, so there are two ways of doing this, and in both ways we're going to use the rate multiplied by time. Actually, I'm going to write this a little further like this. Rate multiplied by time is equal to distance. Multiplied by time is equal to distance. Okay, so now, and also, so this is going to be like a table in both cases. So we label the columns, and now we're going to label the rows. Upstream, downstream, upstream, downstream. Okay, so why are there two ways? The first way is to use hours instead of minutes, because the given rate is given in kilometers per hour. So first let's understand, this number 8 is redundant, we don't need to use it in the math. Okay, 20 kilometers per hour is the still water speed, right? So it means that water is still, and relative to the ground, when you row, when the crew of 8 rows on their boat, they reach 20 kilometers per hour relative to the ground in still water. So that means if they row upstream, they will go slower relative to the ground than 20, and if they row downstream, they will go along with the stream. So that means with respect to the ground level, they will row faster than 20 kilometers per hour. Okay, so for this reason, upstream is going to be less than 20, right? And how much less? 2 kilometers per hour less, right? So we have to subtract 2 from 20 for the rate for the upstream, right? The time is going to be 15 minutes, but be careful, 15 minutes is the total time, the round trip time, right? When they go from point A to point B, right? And then they return from B to A, right? That's the round trip. So the total for this, the total time, travel time for from A to B and then from B to A, the total is going to be 15 minutes. So we can label the upstream time as X. But be careful, X is not going to be minutes. X has to be in hours. And why? Because the rate is given in kilometers per hour. Be very careful. So you have to perform the conversion. Okay, so we have to agree that this is going to be X hours, right? Now, what is the total traveling time in hours? We have to use the conversion factor, right? Take the 15 minutes multiplied by the conversion factor, okay, which means it's going to be a fraction. 1 hour takes 60 minutes. Right, and you got to make sure that your minutes will be in your numerator and denominator, right? Because this can be treated as over 1. So 15 minutes is the numerator, 60 minutes is the denominator, right? So that way you will see that the minutes will conveniently cancel out, and what you should have remaining is the hours as your units. And that's exactly what your conversion in terms of hours for your time will be. Right, so this is going to be 15 over 60 hours, which can be actually simplified to 1/4 of an hour. Right, so X takes something out of this 1/4, right? And then rate multiplied by the time is equal to the distance, right? So the distance takes into account the multiplication of these two guys, right? 20 minus 2 is 18. 18 times X, right, represents the distance, the product of the rate and time. Now, the downstream will be similar, only the rate for the downstream will have to be greater than 20 by the same number, by 2, but greater because water works with you and not against you, right? Water stream is going in the same direction that you're rowing, right, on your boat. So it's going to be plus 2, right? And now, how much time is left? So once they got up to, once they made it from A to B, they have to return from B to A because they're going downstream, the opposite direction, right? So they already traveled, they already spent X hours out of the 1/4 hour time, right? So that means the remaining time is going to be 1/4 minus X hours, right? Because X hours was already spent from A to B. So from B to A, you have 1/4 hour minus X hours left. Okay, so again, you will multiply these two guys, so you will get 22 times 1/4 minus x. And that's going to be the distance. And keep in mind that this is going to be the same distance, right? Because the distance from A to B is the same. The only thing that varies is the time spent and the rowing speed relative to the ground, okay? So as you can see, we can find, the question asks us to find the distance, right? How far did the crew row? So they're telling you basically from A to B, what is the distance from A to B? They're not telling you what is the round trip distance. They're telling you how far, meaning what is the distance from A to B, right? Because if they were to ask you about the round trip, that's not how they would word it in English, right? So you have to basically find 18 times X, that's all. But in order to find 18 times x, you have to find the x value. So in order to do that, we're going to set these two guys equal because they represent the same distances, right? 18x represents the distance from A to B, and 22 times 1/4 minus x represents the distance from B to A, which is the same, right? So 18x is equal to 22 times 1/4 minus x. Now, let's keep solving. 18x is equal to 11 over 2, I'm just reducing, minus 22x. Okay, adding 22x on both sides, we would get, this cancels out, we would get 40x is equal to 11 over 2. Dividing both sides by 40, we will get x is equal to 11 over 80. Now, 11 over 80. 11 over 80 is the time they spent traveling upstream from A to B, right? So now the distance is going to be 18 times this result, right? So 18, so the distance, 18 times 11 over 80. And what are you going to get out of that? 18 times 11 over 80. 18 times 11 over 80 gives you 2.475 kilometers, right? Because the distance is given in kilometers. Okay, so now you might ask me, well, what is the second way? We already found the answer. Well, the second way is to work with minutes, right? So in other words, you're gonna take X hours, I'm sorry, X minutes, right? Now we're talking about minutes. So we're gonna take, well, why don't I say Y variable, right? Y minutes, because X is already given as the hours. So we're gonna do Y minutes. Now the remainder for the trip from B to A will be 15 minus Y minutes, right? Because 15 minutes is the total time spent on the round trip. So in other words, we're not changing the minutes to hours, we're going to work with minutes. But the only thing that you need to change now is the rate, because the given rate is given to you in terms of kilometers per hour. So you have to make it kilometers per minute as your rate, right? Because if you want to work with minutes, you have to be consistent with which time unit you're working with. You can't mix hours and minutes. That's not going to give you the correct answer. Okay, so we're going to work with 18 here and 22 there, right? So let's change 18. That's the rate for the upstream relative to the ground. So 18 kilometers per hour multiplied by the conversion factor. 1 hour takes 60 minutes, right? What is that going to give us? Notice that the hours cancel out and we're left with kilometers per minute, and that's exactly what the rate should be. So 18 over 60 kilometers per minute, and we can actually simplify this. That gives you 9 over 30 kilometers per minute. Okay, so we're going to put this down, 9 over 30, okay, as the rate for the upstream. But the downstream is going to be the same. We're going to take 22 kilometers per hour, right? That's the downstream rate relative to the ground, the rate of the rowing, right, relative to the ground. 22 kilometers per hour multiplied by the conversion factor. 1 hour takes 60 minutes. The hours get conveniently canceled out. And you have 2 units that you should have for the rate. 22 over 60 kilometers per minute, which simplifies as 11 over 30 kilometers per minute. Right, so 11 over 30 is what you're going to put here. So multiplying respectively the rate and time for the upstream and downstream, you're going to have 9y over 30 as the distance, right, kilometers. And this one you're going to have 11 over 30 multiplied by 15 minus y kilometers. So now solving just similarly to the situation with the previous x here, with the y you're going to find the distance using this, because that's going to be simpler than that, right? You can use this, by the way, and you could have used this to find the distance when you found your x value, and this would have given you also 2.475 if you plugged in the x into this distance, because the distances do not change. But for simplicity we could use this one, but for simplicity this one will be easier, right? So once we find the y, we will use this to find the distance. So to find the y, we have to set the equal distances equal, right? So 9y over 30 is equal to this guy, right? Because the distances are the same from A to B is the same as from B to A. 11 over 30, 15 minus y. Okay, so simplifies as 9y over 30 is equal to, let's take the first term, 15 over 30 is 1/2, so 11 2 minus 11y over 30. Adding 11y over 30 on both sides, gives us what? I'm going to write it here. Gives us 20y over 30. Well, 20y over 30 is 2y over 3, right? 2y over 3 is equal to 11 2s, right? Cross multiplying gives you 4y is equal to 33, which gives you y is equal to 33 over 4. Plugging in this y value, I'm going to do it here, plugging in this y value into the 9y over 30, we'll get 9 times 33 over 4 divided by 30, right? So that's the distance, which is equal to, let's see, so 9 divided by 3 is 3. So 3, right? And 30 divided by 3 is 10. So, and then 4 multiplies that. And then 33 multiplies that. Right? So let's see if there's anything more to be done. I don't think so. So let's see what that is. That's going to be 99 over 40. Right, let's see if 99 over 40, what does that give us? 99 divided by 40 is 2.475. 2.4 kilometers. So as you can see, we had the same exact answer as in the first method that we've used. So both of these types of conversions work. You might think that this one is a little harder because it needs more work, but whichever one you choose, as long as you don't mix the the time units like hours and minutes together, or you know, if you misplace the rate or you miscalculate the rate, the upstream and downstream, you should not have a problem with completing this successfully. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in my next video.